मान लेंगे हवाओं का रुख मोड़ के.
Transforming dreams into reality. Graphic Era.
Hello, young friends. Those who are seeking admission in computer science and technology in any of the university. As you know, nowadays there are lot many specializations. This webinar basically focuses how to select the various specializations in computer science and technology. As you know that the computer science and technology has increased tremendously in the last several years, and the courses which are coming into existence are many. Now, if you consider all the courses, it will not be feasible to complete the program in 4 years. Therefore, this has been divided into two major things. One is the core courses, which are necessary for basic foundation of the computer science and technology. Then, after these strong foundation, we have the various specializations, where depending upon the specialization, we give emphasis to a particular domain. The currently several specialization has occurred. One is known as the cyber security. As you know, the cyber security is very, very important nowadays. If there are number of hackers who are destroying the network or destroying the server or any other resources which are in the computers. Therefore, we have to protect all the resources from the hackers. So it is, as long as there is a life in the planet and there is the networking, the problem will always be there. So the basic idea is how to detect the intruder and how to classify the intruder, how to mitigate the effect of the intrusion, and how to trace back the person who are doing this type of mischief. So therefore, the cyber security, it may be at the level of the device level, it may be at the level of network level, it may be at the level of server level, or any other level. It may be in IoT, it may be in cloud, it may be any other level. It is very, very important. You know that if you go to the bank, and if there is server is down, nothing can be done. If network is down, nothing can be done. So therefore, and then if you have all the strategies for your competitive business in the server or for any defense preparation in the server, if somebody takes that particular information, that will be very, very dangerous. So we have to protect our resources from the attackers. And therefore, cybersecurity is very, very important role to play. And therefore, it is essential that people should give more emphasis to the cybersecurity. And then you see that how many bank frauds, how many other frauds are occurring. And therefore, how many personal data are being taken away by the enemies. So therefore, we need to save our resources from the hackers. So this is one of the great area of research. The next area is AI, artificial intelligence. You know that we all know about the natural intelligence. Then what is artificial intelligence? Can you imagine the brain has about 30,000 billion neural cells and about 60,000 billion interconnections. Now you can imagine the role of a brain. Now you cannot replace the brain. The only thing you can do is you can change some of the functionalities of the brain. You can use those functionalities for our benefit. Just like you have game playing. See that once you have the game, in the case of, for example, chess game, initially the computer may lose you the game, but it learns itself from its move, and slowly it is coming efficient, then it will be very difficult to defeat the computer. So that way, and you can talk about expert systems, which are in the very small domain, and expertise is being there. So some functionality of brain see the vision. Now you can find out the driverless car. It is only just like you are viewing a particular pattern. Same way the computer can pattern, view the pattern and make the necessary changes as a result. And similarly, natural language processing, natural language generations, and other type of AI applications, machine learning, where the machine learns out of itself, and then it takes a decision, intelligent decision, based on the circumstances it has. So in that case, AI is going to be playing very important role, especially in the case of robotics and other areas of industries. For example, the industry 4.0 will be using mostly the robotic and other type of expert system, IoTs, other type of domain will be used in that particular case. And next area is the cloud computing. Now, if you see the growth in the computer science, we started with the mainframe computer. Then in the 80s, we have the PC. Then PC were connected. Then PC were connected with the internet. And then internet, again, it was having been connected and have a grid computing, cluster computing, and finally nowadays we are having a cloud computing. And cloud computing is just a sort of service as per pay use, as per use. So if you are needing young entrepreneur, if you need a very high computational power, then you may not have the money to buy and to maintain that particular power. So therefore, it is essential that we hire it as per our need. The only thing we have to do is we have to pay as per our need. We have to pay as per memory we use. We have to pay as per CPU we use. We have to pay as per network we use. And therefore, and this will be very much useful. And if tomorrow the requirement increases, then we are able to increase our requirement. And therefore, the only thing is the data is not in our control. Data is with the service provider. So sometimes the security issues are also very important in this case, where it has to be tackled, the security in the case of cloud computing. And same way that you have edge computing, other type of high performance computing are existing. So that is one specialization where you go to the cloud computing. Then IoT. If you see the industry 4.0, the IoT is playing very important role. Till now, only human beings were connected through internet. Then today, about 6 times devices are being connected compared to the human being. And therefore, this will be increasing substantially, and especially in industry 4.0, which has to be used in most of the domain for industrial domain, for automation, for other type of industry use. And not only industry, but these things are being used in business, competitive business domain to a large extent. Nowadays, we are dealing with lot many data. From the data, we derive the information. From information, we derive the knowledge. And from knowledge, we derive the wisdom. And we use this particular wisdom in day-to-day work, in decision-making, government policies, and other domains. Therefore, it is essential to have the data, because data is going to be a very important aspect. It is a data-driven economy, we can say. Then, in that case, from the data, if you derive the knowledge, then we should know how to manage the knowledge. So there is a new branch which has occurred, which is known as the knowledge management. Then, big data analytics. This is also one of the areas where big data is being taken into care, and especially in the domain of a structured domain, which is known as structured data, semi-structured data, and unstructured data. And data analytics is very important part nowadays, because lot many decisions are being dependent on these data. So if you just take that big data, just like transaction data, financial data, government data, personal data, sales data, promotion data. There are numerous data. Now this branch, I will recommend those people who are having better in mathematics. So because this is basically analytical part, so you should, those who are having a strong mathematical background can go, can select this type of big data analytics. Then in the case of cloud computing, see that the various the applications which are in the healthcare, this is one of the very important applications in the healthcare. Then there are smart cities, smart home, then water quality, environmental modeling, then weather forecasting, and so many areas where it can be used to a large extent. And the beauty of this is you have to use, you have to pay as per use. And therefore, these areas are to be, along with the foundation courses, these areas has to be developed. So you take the foundation course, then plus adding some few courses in big data, and then doing dissertation and doing project in that particular area. Similarly, couple of courses in data analytics and doing thesis work and the project work in this area. Then some of the courses along with the security courses, along with the doing some project and dissertation in security areas. Similarly, in IoT, some of the courses like the sensor networks, then how to communicate, the network can be communicated with various levels, what will be the architecture of that particular level, and then internet, various devices, because you know functionality, if your devices are communicating, the functionality of one device may be changed by another devices. So you have security is also very important aspect in case of IoT. So therefore, similarly in AI case, people can take the core courses plus few courses in AI, just like AI subject, machine learning, and other type of courses, expert systems, natural language processing, computer vision, and the such type of courses in AI, along with dissertation work in these AI courses and the project work. So it will happen that, what will happen that you have a base foundation courses in computer science, and then with specialized courses in different direction that will be useful. Those who are having a good logical skill can take more programming courses. Those who are having good mathematical background can take data analytics. Those who are having more logical as well analytical skill and problem solving skill can take the security areas. And those having software, more software, and then wireless communication, other type of protocols, they can use the IoT. So these are, and then want to use applications in Industry 4.0 can take the IoT course. So this will be very useful if you concentrate more towards the foundation courses, and then from them, from the foundation, you can build up any specialization. I will like to answer any of the queries and questions that you people can have along with my panel.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good morning. Welcome to yet another episode of the Career Guidance Webinars by Graphic Era. First of all, thank you for such a great response and awesome participation. I hope you guys are enjoying this as much as we are, and also we are able to solve some of your queries. Today's webinar was on how to choose a specialization with BTech Computer Science Engineering. We will be having many more webinars in the coming weeks, so stay connected and stay tuned. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to get notified about the same. Today's panel, we have Professor RC Joshi, Chancellor for Graphic Era University. We also have Professor Gangotkar with us, who is Dean International Affairs, also Senior Professor at the Computer Science Department. We will be joined by Akshay Rajput, who is the Assistant Professor at the Computer Science Department also. Now let's move on to our live question and answer session. We have a lot of questions pouring in, so we'll start straight away by the first question, coming all the way from Maharashtra. I hope Maharashtra is doing well, and I hope this it becomes more stable in the coming days. Should only someone who studied computer science in class 12th choose a specialization, or everyone can? Joshi sir, if you would like to answer the question, please.
I think everyone can select the specialization, because it is all market driven. There is a requirement for any specialization nowadays, so therefore you can choose any of the specialization, because we will be teaching the core courses of computer science to everybody, all the specialization, and core courses plus few courses in that specialization will be the specialization. So I think you can choose whether you have done the course or not. You can choose any of the specialization which is required.
Right, sir. Thank you very much. Coming down to the second question, coming from Madhya Pradesh, how do specializations help in the longer run, if they help at all? Joshi sir, if you would like to answer the same question once again, if the specializations help in the longer run.
I think the specialization will definitely, because this is market driven again, as I told you earlier, and if the specialization, now there is a demand in all the industries in computer science of the specialization, and there are lot many jobs in these specialization which are available throughout the world, not only in India but throughout the world. Therefore, there will be a lot of benefit for selecting these specialization.
Great, sir. Thank you very much. Let's move on to our third question, coming from New Delhi. What kind of benefits does one get after choosing a specialization? Gangotkar sir, if you would like to throw some light on that.
Yeah. You see, when we are when we choose a specialization, you know, we are offering Graphic Era University, or any other university for that matter, offers various specializations. Whenever a specialization is chosen, you will be provided with a particular definite set of courses in various semesters that would make you, if not expert, but it will provide you appropriate exposure, you know, by virtue of studying these courses. Therefore, this particular kind of, and then you can also do some certifications in this, which are, you know, which usually are globally accepted certificates. It is better to do globally accepted certificates. So if you do these certificates, those organizations which require people in specific domains, it will be easier for them to analyze your skills, and there are good chances that you will be absorbed in the field of study that you have chosen.
All right, sir. I think that will clarify the question well. Also, sir, one more question for our Dean International Affairs. Sir, do we get international exposure while studying at GEU?
Right. So let me answer this question. You know, yes, Graphic Era University has tied up with various international, renowned international institutions, foreign universities. And we have, you know, collaborations on various fronts. Now, when you say international exposure, we have various, agreements. Like, for example, we invite professors from the foreign universities, and they come here and provide, you know, teach the course. So that is one aspect of it. Second is we send our students through for internship, which could be a small the short-term internship for one or two months, or they can go abroad for a semester, or even they can opt for what is called as a credit transfer program, where the engineering students can choose 2 years of study at Graphic Era, and next 2 years of study they can opt from the partner university, and they would get a degree from partner university. We also have, you know, students coming to us from various partner universities across the globe. So you would also get a kind of an opportunity to work collaboratively and form a kind of a network of the students or the friends who are at globally various universities. So the international exposure is something that you would get in all these aspects at a university.
Great, sir. Thank you very much. Let's move on to our next question. They want to know the difference between cloud computing and data science. Joshi, sir, if you would like to answer that.
I think cloud computing starts from, if you see the entire history of computing, we started from the mainframe, then PC, then PC networking, then networking with the internet, then cluster computing, grid computing, and today's state of art is the cloud computing. In this case, if you are expert in cloud computing, then you can, if your requirement is very high computational, then instead of purchasing high computational computers and instead of maintaining those things, you can hire them. So as per use, you have to pay the rent of the CPU you have used, you have to pay the rent for the memory you have used, you have to pay rent for the network you are using. So you can just get infinite number of computational power by just spending some money on that. As far as data science is concerned, this is everything is nowadays data driven. Whenever the industries are taking, corporate sector are taking any decision, and they are just consulting the data, because from the data you gather the information, from information you gather the knowledge, from knowledge you can gather the wisdom. So the data science is basically used for making a right decision at the right moment.
Thank you very much, sir. Let's move on to our next question now. When will we have a webinar for management studies? Well, you should stay tuned, as I told you in the beginning. Stay connected and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm pretty sure next Saturday, I think we should have our management webinar as well. Also, there will be one more webinar in the middle week, I think on a Wednesday. So stay connected, stay tuned, and look at our social media updates, and you will be informed about it. As far as I'm concerned, I'm pretty sure next Saturday, you should have a webinar on management as well. Let's move on to our next question. So what is the difference between computer engineering and computer science engineering? I think Dean International Affairs, sir, you should answer that. Also, sir, if you can add on computer science technology as well, as CST can be added as well.
All right. See, as far as computer engineering is concerned, this particular field of study involves more of, you know, the system programming and system software related kind of, and, you know, courses. You would have embedded systems you would have also microcontroller kind of, and, you know, developing microcontrollers, as well as utilizing microcontrollers for performing various tasks. For example, you know, you can design a robot. So how are you going to design a robot? For that, you need to design certain circuits, program them. So it's a combination of these, you know, hardware, software, you know, kind of a thing. I think the other question was computer technology, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So computer technology deals with some of the aspects related to the current state of the art technology that is being envisioned or being explored. For example, we have virtual computing, we have computer vision technology, or we have something like video analytics, virtual reality, and so on and so forth. So these are various technological aspects, state of the art kind of an thing, you know, that are dealt in this computer technology.
Thank you very much, sir. With that, let's move on to our next question. Sir, as you know, our exams are delayed. Will the admission process be open for longer? Oh, I think I'll be answering that. First of all, the admissions are already open. You know, you can block a seat based on your credentials, your class 10th scorecard, and also your class 12 projected score. Also, will this take longer? Because, you know, there has been zero loss of any academic hour. As far as Graphicar is concerned, all classes have been doing, proceeding with them online. Secondly, all our three campuses with Hill University as well, these online classes are already going on. Also, the examinations can be done online. Also, they can assignments can be submitted, and you can be evaluated on that. So, we are not pretty sure how long this goes on, Prof, but I'm pretty sure that this can vary a little bit. Not too much, but it will vary a little bit. Let's move on to our next question with that. Sir, I have chosen a specialization already. What more can I do to prepare for the course during these times? Joshi, sir, if you would like to answer this question.
In case you have selected the specialization, so the first thing will be required is the background. So that background has to be strong enough, and you can prepare for the background. Mm-hmm. There are some basic courses. You can learn the programming language. You can learn the operating system. You can learn the networking. Because every specialization starts from these basic fundamental courses. You can strengthen these courses, then you can go for any other specialization.
Thank you, sir. Let's move on to our next question. What is the career path if I choose cybersecurity? I'd also like to welcome Akshay Rajput, who is with us. So, Akshay, why don't you answer this? Career path if I choose cybersecurity.
Okay. So, if you choose cybersecurity, then you will be testing a system at a company, right? And let me tell you that there are only 25% occupancy in the cybersecurity in the companies. So if you choose cybersecurity, there are huge options out there. You can be in a company and you can be testing their servers if they are hackable or not. You may be finding some bugs which hackers can use to get into the systems, and you will be strengthening the systems, and that will be in turn used by the companies to advertise their products outside. So cybersecurity has a huge future aspects if we see the Indian market, because only 25% of the people choose cybersecurity, and only 25% of the seats which are there in the companies are occupied.
Okay, thank you, Akshay. Let's move on to our next question quickly. We are a little short on time already. What parameters should I be considering while choosing a specialization in CS? Joshi, sir, if you would like to answer, please.
Considering for choosing a specialization in CS, for example, the specializations are cloud computing, for example. In this case, if you are more comfortable with the various architectural innovations in the computer science,
so,
and know the want to use the high computational power, and use, if you have job is like that, then you must choose the cloud computing. Then if you want to have data analytics for the data in various domain and derive the extract the informations, extract the knowledge, use the knowledge for the use of the company, for the organization, for the country, then you can use for data analytics. AI systems, which is basically artificial intelligence, and it is a number of applications like machine translation from one language to another language, natural language processing, computer vision, and you have problem solving, game playing techniques. And the only lacuna at this point is how to store the human knowledge into the computer. That right. is the biggest challenge. Mm-hmm. But some of the functionalities of the human brain can be derived by using the AI concepts.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to our next question, coming from Hyderabad. How is the university dealing with the placements during this lockdown? Akshay, I think you're in the best position to answer that.
Yeah. So what we are doing is we have conducted some online classes and online lectures as well. Mm-hmm. And we are using some of the softwares to make videos, and also the programming part. We are teaching students the programming online. Mm-hmm. And we are constantly giving them some hackathons and some competitions, coding competitions on Hacker Earth platform. And that is how we are preparing for this during the lockdown.
So just to put it in simple words, everything is going online, and there's zero loss of academic sessions. There's zero loss of even if there are placements involved. So let's move on to our next question, coming again from New Delhi. Do courses with specializations include meddling as well? Joshi, sir, if you would like to answer, please.
I think the various courses, just like the I mentioned about the cloud computing,
so,
and the AI,
so,
then like the, you have the about the IoTs, the Internet of Things, which is the next revolution of Internet, which is known as the Internet of Things. where the devices are being connected 6 times more than the human being are connected with the internet. And that is a very good area, especially for the industry 4.0, where all the industry standards will be following now as 4.0. That will be very much useful in these particular areas. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to our next question coming from Haryana. What scope is there in engineering for a physics stream student? Joshi sir, will you be able to answer that as well? For a physics stream student.
Initially, if you see that physics stream or any other stream, so every branch is using the computational power nowadays. Mm-hmm. Modeling, molecular modeling, other type of specs, and then number of areas just like biophysics, then bioinformatics. These are the areas which are being opening up nowadays to a large extent. And therefore, any branch can, because if you see that the cross migration program which we started, India started in the 90s,
so
there was very little power, manpower in the computer area. Then anybody having any graduation in any area was given the admission in the M.Tech degree.
Right,
and so that's where the manpower was created. So there are number of areas in modeling, other type of things in physics or biomedical engineering or bioinformatics. There are the scope is unlimited.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to our next question, coming all the way from Bihar. What infrastructure do we have for IoT at the university? So I'm going to direct this to you as well. What infrastructure do we have for IoT in the university?
We have IoT basically has the various type of sensors.
So
first stage, which can communicate through the wireless to the network, and then it goes to the cloud, and then finally for the applications. Then we have implemented the IoT for agriculture.
So
where the various parameters like the humidity, pressure, temperature, and the soil quality, all these things are being monitored. And accordingly, depending upon the conditions, whether the fertilizer is necessary or the watering is necessary, other thing can be controlled that automatically by certain devices.
So
we have implemented this project, how to make use of IoT in agriculture.
Thank you, sir. I think that should ease
and
down the question.
Similarly, we are also having the IoT for smart cities.
Right, so
Monitoring of the very traffic, uh-huh, diverting the traffic,
right,
and water quality, finding
right,
water quality, and the again in the case with the smart homes,
right,
which is being done.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to our next question. Will this academic year be delayed or will it go on as usual? I think I'm going to answer that. I'm not pretty sure that anything is going to go on as usual, but it is how do you adapt to these circumstances? Isn't this what we are being taught? So I think as far as Graphica is concerned, I don't think there should be an extreme loss here. We will be in a very good position as there is a zero academic class that I've told you before. Classes are going online, students are admitting their assignments on time. So I'm not very, very particular whether this is going to be delayed. Yes, it can. There has to be because of this, the virus, I think there will be an adjustment of a few months and which shall be adapted, which shall be managed very, very easily. But will the admission process be longer? I'm not pretty sure because students are already blocking their seats. So be smart. I hope you're not the only one who's waiting. So be smart and take the right decision. You can call us. You can get to our website. And if there's any other questions that come through you, we'll be able to solve them individually as well. Let's move on to our next question now. So while choosing a specialization, should I have some necessary skill set? Joshi, sir, if you would like to answer.
I think there are three type of skills which are needed to develop. One is problem solving skill. How do you view a problem from different angle and find out what is the best possible solution on that? Then second thing is you should have the logical skill. How to logically develop something? And then lastly, you should also have the problem analytical skill, which is very much important nowadays. So development of the analytical skill, development of logical skill, and development of problem-solving skill, these need to be developed.
Great answer, sir. Thank you very much. Moving on to our next question. Do CS students get placed abroad? Well, of course they do, but Akshay, if you would like to throw some more light on that.
Yeah, so Sahib, if you remember, our highest package is of Ujwal Kumar, which got into New York,
SNS
design,
yep.
And it is in New York. So yes, our students do get placed in abroad, and they apply through offline also, and we are also approaching some companies to come to the campus placements. So the short answer is yes, they do get placed abroad,
yep.
And one of the highest packages they get, right?
Yeah, well, also I'd just like to add on, we've had our alumni meets in New Jersey and California,
yeah.
We have close to 1,000 students in the US alone, so no matter what part of the globe you go, you will find a graphic area out there. So that's the legacy batch that's been happening in the last 27 years. Moving quickly to the next question, I want to join the Defense Forces. Which specialization should I choose? Joshi sir, how will you answer this?
I think these are the areas which is common to, for example, defense is a greatest problem is cyber security.
So,
and if you make some strategic plan for the defense forces, and if that is being stored somewhere, and somebody takes out that particular information, now you can imagine mm-hmm. that problem which will have. So the security, you must have seen that a few years back in the DRDO, some of the information was taken out from that. So mm-hmm. the security is very, very important.
Extremely,
at the government
yes.
level, defense level, and other personal security, other type of things are very, very important.
So.
And apart from that, nowadays one can use the IoT, one can also use data analytics, all can be. All these specialization can be equally important for defense personnel too.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much, sir. That makes very good sense. Moving quickly to our next question coming from Dehradun. What is the admission policy of the university for CBSE students who are yet to give exams? Well, as you all know, we are very well aware of the situation. But if you want to block a seat, it is possible. It's a provisional admission that you can do. And what happens is, based on your credentials, based on your class 10th scorecard, based on your projected class 12th scorecard, you can block a seat. There are some conditions that apply to that. But yes, to block a seat, it's already been happening. People are already pouring their questions. They've already taken admissions. So that, you know, what happens is, if you take too much time to think about it, what happens is sometimes the seats go, or if you've already chosen what university you have to go, it's better you just get connected with them and they'll tell you the right way. For CBSE students, there's already a pathway. We know what's happening and you can block a seat straight away. There's no issues. You can log on straight away to the website and you can call our toll frees and they'll help you out. You can stay at the comfort of your home and do the whole process sitting just there. Moving on to the next question. Difference between data science and MLAI. So if you'd like to throw some light on that, and I'll come to Akshay also for that.
I think machine learning AI, it is artificial intelligence,
so
where the knowledge of human being is being stored in some limited domain,
so
and through which you can do game playing techniques,
correct,
problem solving techniques. You can design the expert systems.
Mm-hmm.
You can translate machine translation from one language to another language. Just like you must have seen, observed that any government geo, when it comes, and along with that, automatically translate it into regional languages,
right.
That also is being attached. So we have, India has developed that particular power mm-hmm. to develop the machine translations. So natural language processing, even natural language generation.
So
these are the areas which are computer vision, the driverless car. People have designed a car which can run without any driver.
Mm-hmm.
And then as far as the data analytics is concerned, it is basically analysis of data and basically analyzing the particular data that will help in decision making in any of the domain. It may be a government domain, it may be a corporate domain, or it may be any other domain that can be used. The data has to be analyzed, information has to be extracted, knowledge has to be extracted, then it can be used for decision making.
Thank you, sir. Akshay, what do you have to say on the same question?
So, as I see, data science is a larger picture and ML and AI is a smaller picture inside that. So, when you are learning data science, you have to learn some part of ML and AI as well.
Okay.
Because nowadays, everything is data driven. You have the data, and if you can pick some traits from that data, then that would be a better choice for that. So the basic difference is that ML and AI is a subset of data science.
Thank you, Akshay. Let's move on to our next questions. I think we are coming to the close of this webinar, the live Q&A session also. So we'll quickly take some more questions. Coming all the way again from, I think this is from Mumbai. Can we change specializations during the course? Akshay, would you like to answer that?
Yeah, after first year, you have the provision of changing your specialization only after your first year is done.
Uh-huh.
After that, you cannot change your specialization. And if you are in a core branch, you can take up a specialization after your first semester or first year itself. And that depends, of course, on the availability of the seats also, right, Sai?
Correct, yeah, exactly. Right after your second semester, there's an internal counseling session that takes place. That's the time that if you want to change or skip, a decision can be taken depending on your scores of the first and the second semester as well. Let's move on to the next question. When will we have a mechanical engineering webinar? I think in the coming weeks, as I've told you, subscribe to our YouTube channel and you will be notified about the same. I think next week we are going to have management and we are also going to have a very cozy session on Wednesday, which will be a little more casual in the outdoors maybe. But I think next week you can expect something on mechanical engineering. Till then, if you want, go to the website, get a hold of a counselor, give them a call, drop your messages, we'll be able to answer there. All right, let's go to our second questions. What are the specializations in MCA? Akshay, would you like to answer that?
I think Joshi sir would be the right person to answer this.
So specializations on MCA?
I think specialization, it is all the common branches are there.
Exactly.
In the MCA, there is no specific branch, but one can work in any of the domain.
Right.
Specialization domain for their dissertation or project work. Mm-hmm. Other courses are common.
Perfect, sir. Moving on to our second last question. What was the placement difference between core branch and specializations? Oh, this is a very interesting question. Akshay, yeah. I think you should answer that.
Thank you. So, we have till now is that we had our only the last year, that is the 2020 passing out batch, we had cloud computing and our cybersecurity as the part of the specialization, because the first specialization of data science ML is yet to pass and yet to sit for the placements. The difference between the placement of core branches and cloud computing and cybersecurity branch was that we had some companies, for example, to the new digital, that are only coming for the specialization branch. That only came for cloud computing, that was not for the core branches. But a cloud computing and a person who is doing a specialization can sit for a placement of the core companies as well. So the difference between them is just that they will get specialization, the person who are doing specialization will get some more opportunities than the person who are doing the core courses.
Correct. All right. Very quickly, moving on to our next question. How many mathematical subjects we have in computer science engineering? Akshay, right back at you again.
So I was just counting. It's actually you will have close to four subjects basically.
Uh-huh.
But if you are doing data science and other specialization, then you will have more subjects related to mathematics.
Correct.
In the first year, you will have one mathematics one as your first subject on mathematics. Then in second semester, it's maths two, and then graph theories and discrete mathematics are probably in third and fourth semester. And after that, if you are doing a specialization, you will have some other mathematics course that are related to specifically to your specialization.
Correct. Thanks. Moving on to our next question coming from the Northeast. I think this is from Gangtok. Are online courses helpful during this lockdown? Should we pursue them? Well, I think it's a very, very smart decision during this lockdown. I think this is the best time that you can get online. But just make sure and do your research properly to understand that there's a genuine company backing it up. And the resources that you're putting in through are going towards the right direction. There are a lot of fake websites that just come up and they give you a certification which has zero value. So right before you choose an online course, do your research well. Also, we can help you out with this as well. Call us. One of the counselors will actually also help you to figure out the best company who are in the whatever course you want to do. What are the best websites which are giving you the same thing? Also, they'll help you out to understand whether the course that you're choosing is genuine or not. Moving on to our last question. We are very short of time. What extra effort can we put to add value to our CV so I get higher placement? Akshay, would you like to answer that?
Yeah. So I think this is from the 12th class perspective. So if you are in CBSE or ICSE, you might have studied some programming language like Python, Java, or C++. So my suggestion to you is to get to the problem solving approach. Instead of doing some random course, you go out and you register yourself at HackerRank or HackerEarth and try to solve some basic problems there. And try to make up your approaches towards the problem solving, because most of the companies which come for the placement, they only see if a student has the ability to solve the problems using a programming language. So you can choose any programming language, that doesn't matter. But the main thing is that you should be able to solve some problems. So you can start with that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, with that, we will come to the closing of our live Q&A. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for participating today. I hope you guys solved some of your queries today. So stay safe, stay home, and also special thank you to Joshi sir for taking all the time and being with us, sir, and to our other panelists as well. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great day and take very good care of yourself. Thank you.